But would you sell this domain name for $1 million? Hey, Chris Zuiker with Media Options. Help companies acquire the raw, unfiltered version of their brand and broker in some of the best domains on the planet. So check it out at mediaoptions.com. And my thought today is this, but would you sell it for $1 million? Would you sell it for $500,000? Would you sell it for $2 million? And what I'm referring to are brands that don't own their domain name, and if they did own their domain name. So for instance, we're brokering domains like bloom.com, quilt.com, you name it. Think of all the brands out. Think of like an apple.com. Think of an uber.com. If you went to them today and said, hey, listen, I'll give you $2 million for that domain name, would they sell it? Of course not. I'll give you $10 million, right? Think of Apple. Think of how many people and how many brands would love to own apple.com. And yet, guess what? Like never. It's never gonna be sold. Think of delta.com. Think of carrot.com was announced on domain name wire that they acquired the domain name for $600,000. Now, fast forward a couple years from now, would they sell it for $1 million? No. Would they sell it for $2 million? Probably not, right? Because it becomes this integral part of their company. It's the thing we call brand equity. Now, it's interesting. There's a company, Bring.com, sold for $1 billion to Amazon. I talk a lot about this company. It's a great example. And they bought their domain for $1 million. Now, he equated that domain to be worth over $50 million at the time when he sold Ring for $1 billion. Now, listen. Amazon overnight, in like one phone call, they could have had every single product that Ring owned mailed to their office, and they could have been in the same exact business. They could have outranked them. They could have done a lot of things, but they bought Ring.com for $1 billion because of the thing we call brand equity. They had brand equity. Now, I tell other stories of teamwork.com. I told yesterday the story of cover.com. Now we have carrot.com. Check out domain name Wire. He's doing a podcast next Monday. I think it's going to be a great podcast on that acquisition. Love that domain. Would have loved to buy that domain. But my thought today is this: brand equity. If, like, when you are considering a domain, if you're a brand, and I've reached out to a lot of brands, I have over 90,000 contact points selling domain names. So I have contacts in CMOs, startups, at almost every major company in the United States. Like a lot of companies, a lot of people like me, a lot of people hate me, but. If I'm coming to you and I'm saying, hey, listen, we have your, like, there's this brand that either you could rebrand to, or they're like for the first time, and so their company's decided to sell their domain name and now it's available. How do you evaluate this? Well, one way you evaluate it is this, like, this brand equity thought, this brand equity equation. If we own this today, would we sell it for what they're asking? Now I can tell you that the answer most likely is no, negative, not even for 10 times that amount. Now, I know this also because there's instances where I'm broken on domain name and I reach out on this domain, like we sell it, okay? But because my marketing engine is like still going, because like I've got in front of people, they come back and say, well, how much? You know, or they come back with an offer at a later date. And I tell them it's sold. They say, what? Like, you know, we'll give you like 2 times that. And so sometimes we go back to the company and say, listen, hey, we got this offer. Do you want to just flip it? Now, of course, their answer is no. Their answer is absolutely 100%. Like, unequivocally, never gonna happen. Now this has happened to me numerous times. It actually happened to me in the bidding process. In one instance, like we had a bid come through, we counted them both at the same time. And one person like jumped on it, locked it in. The other person like had all these stipulations, thought we're negotiating, which we were. Ended up losing the domain. They were so devastated that they wanted to offer more. The other company said, no, like this is now gonna be part of our brand. It's gonna be worth much more than what I bought this domain name for. So think about that. Think about that as one of the ways that you can evaluate the impact that this domain would have on your brand and what you would value for if you just owned it and would you sell it. So that being said, hey, if you need any help acquiring a domain name, let me know. Reach out to me, DM me, shoot me an email, chris@mediaoptions.com. Check out the domains we're brokering. Check out my daily podcast. And if you got any value from this conversation, share it up.